One way IT admins monitor large networks is by categorizing network interfaces based on department name, floor number, location, interface type, criticality, etc. Creating groups of interfaces helps an IT admin easily monitor and apply configuration changes to multiple interfaces all at once. This way, the IT admin can reduce much of the manual labor. In this video, you will learn how to group network interfaces in OpManager. Let us use an example of a healthcare organization in the United Kingdom. This organization has 3 branches across the country, serving 100,000 people and employing 4,000 staff at each hospital. As an IT admin, you need to determine the bandwidth capacity for each of these branches and build out a network to meet the current and estimated future demand to ensure consistent quality service experiences. At the same time, you need to avoid capacity underutilization that will unnecessarily inflate capital expenditures. Now, let's see how IT admins can structure and group resources for accurate forecasting, trend analysis, and investment planning. In order to achieve this, I'm going to create groups based on network interfaces for all the departments available in the London branch, and then create a group for the London branch itself and associate all these groups as subgroups to it. By doing this, I can easily view the overall bandwidth usage by branch as well as by specific departments in that branch. First, click on Settings, then select Groups under Configuration. Click the Add button to add a new group. Provide a suitable group name and description and click Next. Select Interfaces from the drop-down menu. Then select the interface property from the criteria list. I'm going to select the interface name. Select the match condition as contains and provide a string in the value field to filter and group the interfaces based on department. Click Next and select the interfaces that determine the health of the group. Click Save. You have successfully created a group for the radiology department. Let me quickly repeat this for other departments like billing and registration. Inpatient lab results. Payroll systems, etc. I will also demonstrate how to associate all these groups to one branch. Click on Settings, then select Groups under Configuration. Click the Add button to add a new group. Put in a group name as London and a suitable description and click Next. Select Groups from the drop-down menu. You can select the groups manually or choose by criteria to filter the subgroups based on group name or type. For this example, let me select the groups manually while associating multiple departments to the London branch. I am going to select the subgroups from the available members list and move them to the selected members list. Click Next and select the subgroup that determines the health of the group. Click Save. You have successfully created a group for the London branch. Go to the group dashboard to view the summary. This provides information about the list of interfaces available in the group and interfaces that had problems in the past. This is how OpManager helps IT admins group interfaces together for organized network management, making it easy to push bulk configurations. The best part is reports, widgets, and interface templates can all be created for groups and subgroups in OpManager. Generating the report for this group helps you forecast the capacity utilized based on historical trends and helps you plan your bandwidth expenditure judiciously. That's it for now. I hope this helps you manage your IT infrastructure more efficiently. For more information about grouping network interfaces in OpManager, refer to the links in the description below. Thanks for watching. To stay up to date with the latest videos exploring OpManager's features, subscribe to our channel, OpManager Tech Videos.